We are not the news. We are the Macau news. Believing us is like believing Beijing is the capital of China.
Can we start? Welcome to the Macau news. My name is Brad Pitt.
And my name is Angelina Chun Li.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, recently our building feels greener. Why?
Because of green innovation.
Oh, what's that?
Green innovation is...
So what are some examples?
Clean Tech 1.
We're very lucky to have with us today Mr. Lin Laobei, the CEO of JTC Clean Tech Park. Mr. Lin, can you tell us more about the environmentally friendly business park?
Sure. CleanTech 1 is Singapore's first eco-business park. Our first development in CleanTech Park is CleanTech 1, which is 2-towered and 60 stories high.
I see. So, can you tell us more about the green features of the park?
Our business park focuses mainly on developing and using some of the coolest and newest green innovations. These innovations can be categorized into three main categories: utilizing renewable energy, building cooling, and waste management. All these innovations help to reduce waste and energy consumption, which helps to save a lot of money for the company.
The building houses a 1 megawatt polymer electrolyte membrane fuel cell. To generate electricity and heat, the two input resources are hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen is produced through a process called thermal plasma reforming, where it uses horticultural waste to generate hydrogen. In a fuel cell, the positive hydrogen ions and negative hydrogen ions will be splitted, and the negative hydrogen ions will travel along an external circuit to generate electricity. The electricity generated is expected to power up to 38% of the building's estimated energy load. Any excess energy generated can be stored in the electricity grid and will only be utilized when needed. Hence, this green innovation aims to eliminate pollution caused by the burning of fossil fuels, which is the conventional method of generating electricity. The input resources are abundant and easily obtained. Such energy sources are also renewable, and since energy generated can be stored, it prevents wastage of energy and electricity, thereby resulting in cost savings.
Now we have with us one of the tenants from the CleanTech 1, Ms. Viviana.
Hello everybody. My name is Viviana Santiano, that's right, and I'm the president of the Aspergers, that's the Singapore Pantene Girls, yeah. So now I start to use this PM fuel cell, and my electricity bills reduced by 35%. Last time my bills used to be about $30,000, but now it's about maybe about $30, yeah. And also now the water is only the byproduct, so I don't smell like a fish market anymore. And last thing is because Viviana like to buy branded goods, so I can now buy more of my Louis Vuitton, Agnes B, and also Hermes. Thanks everybody, thanks!
Now let's see how JTC CleanTech 1 cools its building.
Solar desiccant cooling. It is an efficient process that helps to dehumidify the air while cooling it at the same time. It employs the use of liquid desiccants, a substance that is able to naturally absorb moisture from the air. The unit consists of the conditioner and the regenerator. The conditioner contains cool liquid desiccants, which draws warm, humid air from the outside. The air that enters will pass through the cool desiccant and moisture will be absorbed, thus cooling and drying the air. However, to keep the desiccant solution concentrated, excess water will be transferred to the regenerator, where the same process will take place in a reversed manner. The surrounding air will enter the regenerator, pass through the hot liquid desiccant, and the hot air will evaporate the water content in the desiccant. Therefore, even though the room is kept at 26 degrees Celsius, employees will still feel comfortable and cool because it is not humid.
Now, we have with us Ms. Cuckoo, a researcher of cooling the building. So, Ms. Cuckoo, what's your take on this?
你好,我是Cuckoo. Speak at you, okay. My name is Cuckoo, and I feel that, number one, this 科技 and the ability to cool the air is not same. Outside, the 空气上升, and inside, the ability to cool the air decreases. And 新加坡这么热, I wonder if the technology can really cool the air properly. And number two, this technology uses a lot of tin. but sometimes, maybe the tin we save from not using the normal systems may be more than the energy we use in these systems. And also, JTC uses the most efficient system. JTC 赞.
Now, let's find out more about food waste management at CleanTech 1. Look, there's an uncle over there. Let's go and find out more. Hi, uncle. Good afternoon.
Oh, hi.
Do you happen to know what is a biodigester?
Biodigester? Oh, I handle this on a daily basis.
Oh, good. So you can explain to us how does it work?
Yeah, sure.
These are found everywhere from leftover food to unsold products at the end of the day. Current disposal methods are either through incinerator plants or dumping at landfills. Not only does the former require a fee, it pollutes the air too. For the latter part, the land used for dumping food waste could have been put to better use as land space will run out with time. Therefore, this is where a biodigester comes into the picture. How a biodigester works. First, food waste is added into the biodigester machine. A mixture of water and proprietary biological agent is then poured in, whereby enzymes and microbes help to accelerate decomposition. As the additives break down and liquefy the food waste, it allows for the transformation of organic solids into grey water. Advantages. This substantially reduces the weight and volume of organic waste. Additionally, it liquefies organics to the point where it can be disposed through existing sewer system, eliminating the need for hauling altogether. Disadvantages. The cost of the biodigesters usually outweighs the economic benefits of recycling food waste. Next, it produces grey water which contains relatively high level of biochemical oxygen demand. BOD is corrosive to plumbing and contains high levels of non-beneficial bacteria. Some other disadvantages will include a lack of regulation for a proper installation and discharge of food waste, a high wastage of water, and conjugation of waste.
So, are there any better alternatives to the biodigester?
Maybe the EcoWaste Eco-Digester. Because I heard it produces lesser grey water and more reusable water. Then another alternative can be the dehydrators, you know. The dehydrators, right, uses less water. Then also produces less, you know, they call it BOD. BOD. Yeah, so it's more efficient in that way.
That was so informative. Thank you, Uncle. Now, back to you, Brangelina.
Indeed, CleanTech One has many examples of green innovations. Wow.
But such green culture is not widely adopted in Singapore.
Yes, I agree. The government should do something about it, like partnering with private sectors.
Can you imagine if everybody in Singapore adopts green innovation? The world will be much more sustainable.
That's right.
Thank you, everybody, for watching the Macaw News.
See you next week.